Hello chess fans, this is Rick from Chess to Impress with a video on the impossible position. This position is from round one of the 2017 Blitz Championships played on the 29th of December 2017. White is the classical world champion Magnus Carlsen, black is the Russian grandmaster Ernesto Inarkiev, and this is the position after Inarkiev's 27th move, knight d5 to e3 check. But that is impossible, because as you can see here on the screen, the rook on b7 is giving check to the black king, and the knight on e3 is giving check to the white king, so something went wrong here. Let's look at how this position arose. The players had just played 3 days of rapid, with Vishwanathan Anand as the new world champion, and ahead of them lay 2 days of blitz, a total of 21 rounds, and this was the first round. Carlsen was white, Inarkiev was black, e4 from the classical world champion, c5, and a3. Carlsen had prepared some unusual openings for the Blitz World Championship. Here g6 is the main move, as commented by Grandmaster Mirosnichenko in a live broadcast, to avoid, as he said, getting white what he wants, which is the half-open A and B file and an advantage in development. But Inarkiev did not play g6, he played knight c6. b4, c takes, a takes, knight takes, so that's a pawn sacrifice from white. d4, there's white's strong center. d5, challenging the center. c3, kicking the knight. Knight went back to c6. e takes d5, queen takes d5. Knight a3, bishop f5, and white can develop here with knight f3 to get quicker development because of tempo moves against black's exposed queen. He will be able to develop some pieces with a tempo on the queen. But Carlsen decided not to play knight f3, he decided on knight b5. He's threatening knight c7 with a very, very nice fork on king, queen and rook. So black's reply is forced. Rook c8 to cover the c7 square. And Carlsen played, after quite a think, knight takes a7. The time control for the blitz was 3 minutes per game plus a 2 second increment per move. And here Ernesto Inarkiev used a full 2 minutes, so two-thirds of his time, to play knight takes a7. He must have looked at other variations. He must have looked at the rook returning back to a8. And then Carlsen has knight b5. And you cannot take on a1 because of that fork again that we just saw. It's winning the queen. But of course, after knight b5, black doesn't have to take on a1. He can play queen e4 check as an in-between move. But then, bishop e3 to seal the check. And at the same time, now the rook on a1 is protected. But as said, after knight takes a7, Inarkiev decided not to play the rook back to a8. He played knight takes a7 after a 2 minute think. Carlsen took immediately. e5, also immediately played. Of course, Inarkiev had calculated the variations during those 2 minutes. Knight f3, e takes d4, knight takes d4, and bishop d7. And that is against the bishop coming to b5 with tempo. That would have been a check. And then white does not have to worry about what queen takes g2 would be. So that's why knight d7 is a good move, practically a good move. If you now play bishop e2 developing, then black can take, but then white can play bishop f3. It's a pawn sacrifice, but white has now very good and quick development, while black's kingside is still completely undeveloped. But Carlsen did not play bishop e2. Sorry for those arrows, let me get rid of them. He played another move. He played the knight to b5 here. The queens were swapped, and bishop c6. And again, can white develop his bishop? He may then lose the g2 pawn. Carlsen played bishop d3. If you now take on g2, there is rook e1 check, king d8, and bishop f5. And this is very good for white. All his pieces are playing while black's king side is still undeveloped. It's worth a pawn. So after bishop d3, Inakiev decided not to take on g2, he played bishop c5, attacking the rook. Rook e1 check, developing the rook with a tempo on the king. Knight e7, and of course our rook is still hanging, but Carlsen played a brilliant move, bishop a3. And if you now take that rook, that's not good, because rook takes e7 check is a good in-between move that wins a piece. King d8, and then you take on a7. And for example, rook c7, knight takes e6, b takes e6. White has two bishops for a rook. And these bishops are very strong. White has a great position here. So after bishop a3, Inakiev did not take the rook on a7. He played bishop takes a3, rook took back, rook d8, attacking the bishop, knight d4 to deal with that problem, and king d7. Here it was visible from the broadcast that Carlsen reached for his f-pawn to play f3, but then he changed his mind and played rook a7 instead. If you now take on g2, then there is f3. You can also play rook g1, and that's okay for white. So after rook a7, Inakiev decided to develop his h-rook, rook he8, king c2, king c7, rook b1, rook b8, finally f3, no more bishop takes g2 moves to calculate. Knight d5, Carlsen took on c6, king took back, and he played bishop b5 check. And this looks like it's winning an exchange because of this skewer, but black still has a move. King b6, counterattacking white's rook. Here Carlsen played rook takes b7 check. Both players were very low on time. And instead of dealing with the check, Inakiev played knight d5 to e3. My software is not even allowing to make that move because black is in check. And after knight e3, Carlsen did not claim, did not call the arbiter, did not stop the clock to claim a win. He played king c2 to d3. He was confused as well. And then Inakiev stopped the clock, claiming that Carlsen had made an illegal move. The arbiter came to the board and agreed with Inakiev, and Carlsen shook Inakiev's hand in resignation, and Inakiev had won a point. Very curious, how did Carlsen play an illegal move? Of course it was first Inakiev who had played an illegal move. Knight e3 was not legal, but because Carlsen did not react to it and played another move, then Inakiev claimed an illegal move and won the game. But the head arbiter, who was at another board at the time of the incident, rectified the situation and gave Carlsen the win. Inakiev put in an appeal, which was rejected by the appeals committee, and white, Magnus Carlsen, won this game and went on to win many more games and become World Blitz Champion 2017. Here is the moment that Inakiev claims the win. He had stopped the clock. You can see the black king there being in check. You can see the white king on d3. The move that Carlsen had played after Inakiev gave a check with the knight. And this arbiter, as I said, agreed with Inakiev and awarded him the win because of Carlsen's illegal move. But it was then turned over by the head arbiter, and I think that was the right decision. Also supported by the laws of chess. Hope you liked this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe to the Chess to Impress channel. Please leave a comment. And if you liked the video, it would be great if you could share it on social media. You also may want to check out my Chess to Progress channel. The link is in the description box. This is Rick for Chess to Impress. Thank you for watching.